Hey everyone, welcome to episode number 11 of The Download. My name is Kenny, and this week I am doing a gameplay here on ETS2. Welcome you guys to the 11th episode of my channel. Very excited to do the video, as I am each and every week. Oh man, here we are back again in ETS2. Got some stuff to tell you guys today, but before I get into all the good stuff, we're gonna waste no time. We're gonna jump inside the truck, get everything fired up, go over our pre-trip information, and we can get trucking. So let's go ahead and do that now. Alrighty guys, welcome aboard. And today we are taking the Volvo FH Globetrotter XL series. Very nice looking truck. They got the FH16 logo on the side there on the inside panel. Very good. Alright. So let's go ahead and get everything started up here. 1, 2. Alright guys, so today we're going to be hauling some canned pork. Nothing like eating meat out of a can. Yummy. 49,515 pounds is our weight. And we're going to Poznan, I think. With a little slash above the A there. Oh boy, a little bit of a longer trip today. 367 miles, I believe, we're going to be going today. So, before I go anywhere, I do want to tell you guys that I am feeling a little under the weather. I'm dealing with a cold right now. Weather's been going from good weather to not so good weather. And everywhere in between. It's been very mild this winter. Everyone's getting sick. Yours truly's also got a touch of the cold, so. But the show must go on, so. Just letting you guys know, I'm not going to be talking a whole lot during the video, but I do have a little bit of a story that you guys may find interesting. But as always, I'm going to get out onto the main road, and then I'll talk. So let's go ahead and do it. Let's get the hell on out of here. Alrighty, so, as I said, I am dealing with a cold right now. It's been very, very mild the past several weeks here, as we head into mid-March and April soon coming up. We all know that once the good weather hits, you know, everyone wants to try to get outside and enjoy the good weather. And I don't blame anyone for that at all, actually. The weather's been beautiful. And, what the fuck? Come on. Thank you. I've seen a lot of people in short sleeve shirts and shorts and sandals, and I'm like, are you guys serious? It's like March. It's March, okay? It's still winter. I don't care what anyone says. It's still winter. Deal with it, you know? That's how you're gonna get sick. But, you know, I unfortunately got a little touch of it myself, and I got to deal with it. And luckily, I'm not the kind of person that gets sick very often, which is a good thing. But yeah, so I hope you guys all liked the video I posted last week in ACS. And I'm going to be doing a lot more videos on that. What I'm thinking about is putting up like a blooper and outtakes video. Not entirely sure though. I gotta hammer down some good bloopers and outtakes first to put a piece of video together, but I was thinking about doing that. See, I don't want to go around this guy because it's... If I can try to find some room up here. Well, it's a speed limit anyway, so wouldn't do me any good. Hope everyone had a fantastic St. Patrick's Day. Even though some people out there are not Irish, you can still go out and have a good time. Get yourself a nice Reuben or corned beef and cabbage. I'm not a big cabbage person, but I'll tell you what. The restaurant where I work at puts on a really good corned beef and cabbage every year. One of my favorites. So, yeah, definitely get out, enjoy yourselves, and I hope everyone had a great holiday. Technically holiday, right? Okay, so, like, I have a little bit of a story to discuss with everyone. Everyone needs to kind of understand where I'm coming from here. It's a very common issue that happens to everyone somewhere when they work. It's just something for me to rant about because... The last several weeks, when I've been working, it's been getting worse. What I'm talking about is public restrooms. This is like a hot button issue for me because people have absolutely no regard for the health and safety of other people. And it irks me to absolute no end. Like, you guys ever go into a public restroom, whether it would be at a fast food restaurant or just any kind of eatery, typically a restaurant or an establishment where they have bathrooms for customer use. Go in there and the bathrooms are a complete disgusting mess. It's gross. It makes you feel very uncomfortable when you're trying to, you know, take care of your business and there's toilet paper on the floor, which I'm going to get into very lengthy in a minute. There's water on the floor, there's soap splattered on the counters and sinks. Like, there are people who work there that are able to clean all that up. You should be able to walk into a bathroom with absolutely no worry of stepping into a puddle of water or having to deal with no paper towels in the dispensers. That has got to be like, especially in toilet paper though, what really drives me up the frickin' wall is when you go into a bathroom at a public place and there's always got to be like toilet paper everywhere on the floor. It doesn't matter what it is. You go into like the stalls and like in the corner of the stall next to the toilet and the wall, there's got to be like people, I swear, put like a pile of toilet paper in the corner. Why do people feel that it's okay to randomly throw toilet paper everywhere on the floor? I deal with it at work, okay? And, you know, I work for Tim Hortons. It's a broad statement. But I've noticed that every time I clean the bathrooms, there is always someone somewhere out there who will walk into those bathrooms, walk out, and then when I go to clean them, because it's part of my responsibility on my shift, and I go into the stall and I find little bits and pieces of toilet paper everywhere. Long strands of toilet paper everywhere on the floor, and I find a like couple piles of it stuffed in the corner. Like, who does that? Like, seriously, what kind of person does that? I don't know if it's like a little kid that does it or even some grown-ass adult goes in there. And I'm not excluding anyone either. Women are to blame too. Men and women are, like, especially women are just as guilty as men are. No one is excluded. I don't care who you are. It's fucking gross. Every time I go to clean the bathrooms, I always find a fancy assortment of toilet paper stuffed in the corner of the stall. It's disgusting. As if to say that someone goes in there, decides, oh, I'm gonna make a mess of the bathroom, then just start randomly throwing toilet paper all over the fucking place. Like, are you serious? Like, I don't know what is going on with people, but it's disgusting. it pisses me off to no end. Why do people have to go into a public restroom and feel like they need to destroy the toilets and not flush? It's just one of those things that it's an ongoing issue because people are fucking slobs. People are fucking slobs. They have absolutely no regard for other people. If they are not home in the privacy of their own home in their own bathroom, why should they have to worry about picking up their own mess in a public place? Just give me a few pointers on that, will ya? Cause that pisses me off. Especially women. Okay, now I know there are some people out there who are complete germaphobes, and that's okay. But let me tell you something. We live in a world filled with germs. I find, you know what, I'm going to say the same thing for men too, because both genders are just as bad. I go in there and I find that people place toilet paper on the toilet seat when they go to sit down and do whatever they got to do. Which I think, I don't know. People are weird. People are fucking weird. At least have the decency of a human being to flush that paper down the drain, please. Don't leave your disgusting toilet paper on the seat for the next person to take care of it. It's fucking gross. Why do people have to be such fucking slobs? You know, it's like at the restaurant I work at, you know, which is a bar, you know, people think that they can, you know, hold their liquor, and then before you know it, they feel like they gotta upchuck, but they do it in the sink. They go into the bathroom, they do, you know, they can't find the toilet because, you know, obviously you can't really hold your own vomit. You gotta upchuck it in the sink. Or even in the men's urinal, for crying out loud. I've had to clean up messes like that. It's disgusting. But, what can I say? Human beings are fucking slobs. Let this guy go. By the way, I hope you guys enjoy the music that I'm playing on the radio here. Some good quality trance music. as I said, I do apologize for not talking as much as I normally do. Been dealing with a scratchy throat for the past couple days, and rather not aggravate it any more than I have to, but I would feel bad if I didn't upload a video for you guys. Might be going to Vegas next week in ACS. I'm very excited about that. Can't wait. Set my cruise to 45 here. I love how this truck handles though. It's very nice and fluid. Try to pick up the speed a little bit here. Car just slammed into me, into my trailer. I don't know if you guys saw that or not. Didn't cause any damage, so that's a good thing. Oh man. I find this game very relaxing. Like, I'm sure most of you guys don't know already. I mean, when you think of this game, you think, oh, you're just driving a truck, you know, how can this be any fun? Honestly, I think this game is very relaxing, kind of therapeutic if you think about it. This would be an excellent game to play if you're actually going to become our actual truck driver. Cannot wait for summer. The last couple of weeks have been very, very mild. Highly unusual weather for this time of year, for March. Summer is like my favorite season. I like winter, but I mean, You can only take so much of the cold before you say enough is enough. So my cruise back to 55. Got about 91 miles to go now. My game is glitchy. Why is this game glitching? Looks like we got a toll gate coming up here. This is a smooth trip so far. I'm loving it. As I said, sorry for not talking so much as I normally would. Battling a cold right now, but it is what it is. The show must go on, right? Want to keep everyone happy, happy. Loving this music right now. Got about coming up on 50 miles now. We got our toll gate ahead too, looks like. Actually, that's for the other side actually. Damn. I know I can pass on the left lane, I do believe, so I'm actually going to go do that. I love this game. This and ACS both are amazing games. Set our cruise back to 55. I had no idea we were on the A2 the whole time. Shit. Less than 25 miles at our destination here, coming up. That's 30. Holy shit. I know the speed limit drastically drops when you enter a toll gate area. Dude, what are you doing? Go! It got 50 miles to go. Beautiful. Entering our home stretch. Well, that came up quick. Beautiful. Made it to our destination. Awesome. I think the name is pronounced Poznan. I believe that's Poznan. Poznan or Poznan? Put my signal a little bit too early, but it's alright. All right. gonna take it. Sorry, I can straight back it now if I can try. That's good enough. All right. As I said before, I'm not going to spend any more time in these videos trying to make sure things are absolutely perfect. As long as I'm in that green rectangle that's lit up, it'll be accepted. So we're gonna shred everything off here. Set. There you go. Alrighty, so that's it. That is another very successful trip here on ETS2. But yeah, hope you guys enjoyed the video, and like I said, sorry that I haven't been talking much, trying to get through a cold here thanks to our lovely Mother Nature. But I would have felt very bad if I didn't upload some sort of a video for you guys. Even though I'm not feeling my greatest, I still have to work, live life and do the things I have to do. Can't let my people down. So all right, there you go. So that is episode 11 of The Download. Hey, guess what? I'm going to Vegas next week, so can't wait for that, hopefully, and ACS. So alrighty. Well, I will let you guys know what's going on for next week's episode. Can't wait, but I'm going to wrap it up right here. All right, guys. So this has been episode 11 of The Download. My name is Kenny, saying your download is ready. All righty, guys. Take it easy. I'll see you next week. Bye-bye.